How's it going, everyone? Prestige here, bringing episode number 4 of The Road to Prestige. I'll be covering Prestige 4 this time with an awesome game of Capture the Flag on Nuketown 2025. I hope you all enjoy. This is actually a pretty exceptional game with the dual-wielded executioners, so sit back, relax, enjoy the commentary and the gameplay. I'm going to be talking about the EMP grenades and how much assist points you can get right y'all. And I'll also be talking about that nuke video that's been floating around, how to get a nuke on Black Ops 2. That's completely just a troll video, I'll say that right now, but we'll go more in depth with it in just a second. What I'm rocking in this class is purely dual-wielded executioners. This is the perfect Capture the Flag class, in my opinion. You got Ghost, Flak Jacket, you're rocking your scavenger, so you can always have ammo and EMP grenades, and you got Extreme Conditioning and Tac Mask, so if any of them have shock charges or bouncing Bettys all over the objective, if you happen to run into it, you're not going to die. You'll be able to get their flag, get in, get out, capture it, and get the win for your team. And this is just something that happened. Guardians are an excellent kill streak to use while playing this objective. And you're definitely going to see them being used right here because my teammate had one, I had one, and then I ended up getting a third one. So we actually have three of them covering the objective. So what I decided to do was put it kind of catty-cornered over there so if an enemy dropped down, they wouldn't be able to destroy the other Guardian right away. And it would still have sort of like that balancing ground. And that's something that I enjoy. But let's talk about this tactical nuke video. I will say one thing about the video itself. The nuke emblem for the score streak in the score streak slot looked very, very legit. It looked almost like it's supposed to be there. Whoever edited that in with the movie magic is definitely, I mean, that definitely looked real. The fact of the matter is, when David Vonderhaar tweeted it out and was like, oh, let's start a riot, I don't think that was one of the best moves to do, because that made almost, it made it just explode. And people thought it was real. He didn't really explain it. And people, I mean, this video came from the same guy that made How to Get a Golden Riot Shield. It came from the same guy that made How to Take Out a MOAB with a Javelin Missile. And that's just something that people of a younger age don't really understand, because a while back I made a Road to Gold for the Riot Shield for Modern Warfare 3. And people were actually saying, people believe that How to Get a Golden Riot Shield is real. And that's something that I think is very, I don't know how to explain it. It's just kind of weird. But guys, I assure you, there is no nuke in Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Why would there be a game-ending nuke? That doesn't make any sense. Why would you have to play free-for-all and get a 25 kill streak? Why would it then be unlocked for every other game mode? Doesn't make any sense. It's not real. Do not believe it. I'm just here to give you truth, and that's what I've been telling you guys for months on end, and that's just truth right there. So let's talk about the EMP grenade, because as you seen in the beginning, they had, I think, 2 bouncing Bettys on it and 2 shock charges, and what happened was I threw the EMP grenade, it exploded and took out every piece of equipment on that flag, giving me plus 200 for my score streak, and that's as much as killing an enemy while holding the flag, and that is actually a huge amount of points towards your score streaks. One thing that I enjoy about the EMP grenade is if you're using the EMP grenade and you throw it you could throw it literally anywhere. Just throw it anywhere on the map. If you end up getting a hit marker on an enemy and the teammate takes him out, you'll get plus 50 for an assist, and that's plus 50 towards your score streak. Think of it this way. If you shoot a bouncing Betty without using an EMP grenade, you just shoot it with your weapon to take it out, you're actually going to end up getting plus 50 for your score streak anyway. So if you throw an EMP grenade, say you take out a bouncing Betty, there's plus 50. Another shock charge, there's another plus 50. You're already at plus 100. Say you get 2 enemies, you're going to get another plus 100. So you're going to get plus 200 towards your score streak right there. And that's actually a really easy way to get actual score streak points. And another thing about the EMP grenade is it acts a lot differently in this game. It actually goes through walls. You could throw it straight up in the air. It'll go through trucks, buses. It will just hit a surrounding area with a certain radius. And I thought that was actually a really cool thing to do. But I don't know what your guys' opinion is. One thing that I did want to talk about right before the end of this video is, and I just wanted to get your opinion too, when I'm playing a game mode like Capture the Flag or Hardcore Team Deathmatch, I'm not saying I play Hardcore Team Deathmatch, but I get really annoyed when I have to wait, like, with a respawn time. I don't understand. Like, I just get so furious. Like, it just aggravates me. But when I play a game like Search and Destroy, I love it. I don't know why. I can't get enough of Search and Destroy, even if I have to wait because I died. It's just something that I enjoy. I hate having to wait to respawn, but I love playing Search and Destroy. It's kind of really, it's actually kind of weird. But, guys, that is all I got for this episode of The Road to Prestige. The next episode will actually be my fifth Prestige. I'm almost there. And you guys can expect to see the Golden Executioners. I will use them dual-wielded again for total sexiestness. Sexiestness? I just made that word up because they're cool. So I'm going to use the dual-wielded Executioners for the next Road to Gold because a lot of you wanted to see them. For the fifth Prestige episode, I'm actually going to be giving you my halfway report because, I mean, I made it halfway through the ranks. I'm going to give you my halfway report of how the game felt when I got it, how the game felt through my level progression, and how the game felt for me now. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, even though towards the end I kind of got a little fuzzy with my words. But if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like. If not, that's cool. And keep in mind, I am on the road to 20,000 subscribers. We are less than 400 away. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And until next time, I am out. Peace.